Hello, good morning dear friends. Welcome back. We are starting after Diwali vacations and I hope you have enjoyed your Diwali safely and followed all the rules and regulations about COVID-19 given by the government of India. So now today we are starting with our syllabus. We are moving forward. But before that, I just want to remind you about our syllabus, what we have studied before Diwali vacations. You have studied one prose chapter, that is, On to the Summit, We Reach the Top by Tenzing Norgay. Historical adventure, getting to the top. Okay. After that, in poetry, you have studied one poem, Cherry Tree, written by Ruskin Bond, Indian poet, and that poem also gives a great message about how to live a life, how to face problems in life. Okay. After that, in writing skill, you have studied summary writing, note making, then we have studied figures of speech also. Okay. After that, you have studied history of English drama. And related with all these syllabus, you have given one unit test also. Okay. So now after Diwali vacations, we are moving forward and we are starting with prose section. Ki sutti cha aadhi tumhi ha part atta parin shiklela aat. But now we are starting with our prose section. And I want to start with 1.3. The Call of the Soil. A Scent of Rice. We are on page number 25. I hope the textbooks are in front of you. I want textbook in front of you. Pratyekacha samor mala tesa textbook paije. We are on page number 25. Okay. The Call of the Soil. A Scent of Rice. Title is very interesting. The Call of the Soil. Now you all know the meaning of these words. A call. The call. And of the soil. Soil manje mati. The call of the soil means return to the nature. Call of the soil. Your mother earth is calling you. A scent of rice. Now these two titles are there. You can see. First title is a big. The call of the soil. While comparing to that, a scent of rice is in short. Two short stories are there. The call of the soil and a scent of rice. You will come to know about the importance of this title later. We will discuss it. Okay. So now, like all the chapters, we are going to start with icebreakers. Now all of you are familiar with this technique, icebreakers. Icebreakers are used to motivate you, encourage you or to create interest in whatever you are studying. This is called as icebreakers. कि आइस ब्रेकर्स हा पार्ट तुम्ही पहिल्या चॅप्टर साठी पण शिकलेला आहे, पोएम साठी पण शिकलेला आहे. की आइस ब्रेकर्स हे कशासाठी असतात, की हळूहळू तुम्हाला त्या पार्ट मध्ये घेऊन जाण्यासाठी किंवा टू अराउज युअर इंटरेस्ट इन दॅट पार्ट. तुमचा इंटरेस्ट आवड त्यामध्ये हळूहळू निर्माण करण्यासाठी असतात. अँड यू ऑल नो दॅट आइस ब्रेकर्स गिव्ह यू अन आयडिया व्हॉट इज देअर इन दॅट टेक्स्ट. की त्या टेक्स्ट मध्ये नक्की काय याच्याबद्दलची आयडिया देण्यासाठी का असतात icebreakers. So we'll start with first icebreaker. You are on page number 25 and I want you to write these answers in your textbook with me, please. First one, discuss the following with your partner and complete the following sentences. One is done for you. You can discuss with each other. Now you are sitting at your home. I know this thing. So just pay attention. First one is done for you. What is the first one? Okay, before eating apples. Now from this first sentence, you will come to know that this text is related with eating or food. Before eating apples brought from the market, what we do? Answer is given. I wash and peel them off. We wash the apples or whatever fruits we brought from the market. We wash them. Nowadays we are going to sanitize them and all these things are there. और वी वॉश देम विथ अ लिटिल बिट सॉल्ट इन इट. बरोबर आहे. मीठ घालून सुद्धा आपण भाज्या सध्या काय करतोय, भाज्या फळं धुतो. वाय वी वॉश देम अँड पील देम ऑफ. ओके, वाय वी विल सी लेटर ऑन, का ते नंतर बघू आपण. पण आपण काय करतो, वी वॉश अँड पील देम ऑफ. सेकंड बी, व्हॉट इज बी? इन अ फार्मर्स मार्केट. नाउ फार्मर्स मार्केट मीन्स दिस टेक्स्ट ऑर दिस इज रिलेटेड विथ फार्मिंग, शेती. फार्मर्स मार्केट मध्ये काय काय सापडतं आपल्याला? वी फाइंड व्हेजिटेबल्स अँड फ्रुट्स. काय सापडतं? व्हेजिटेबल्स अँड फ्रुट्स. वन मोर आय वॉन्ट टू ऍड, ग्रेन्स. ग्रेन म्हणजे धान्य. धान्य सुद्धा असतं ना शेतकऱ्याच्या बाजारपेठेत. व्हेजिटेबल्स अँड फ्रुट्स. नेक्स्ट वन, फूड ॲडल्टरेशन. मीन्स आता ॲडल्टरेशन, न्यू कन्सेप्ट इज देअर. आतापर्यंत फर्स्ट ए अँड बी वॉज रिलेटेड विथ फूड. ॲपल्स धुवून घ्यायची, आपल्याला फार्मर मार्केटमध्ये काय सापडतं? व्हेजिटेबल्स अँड फ्रुट्स. आता ही एक नवीन कन्सेप्ट आली बघा, फूड ॲडल्टरेशन म्हणजे काय? मीन्स काय? ॲडिंग अ स्मॉल क्वांटिटी ऑफ नॉन न्यूट्रिशियस सबस्टन्सेस इंटेन्शनली टू इम्प्रूव द अपिअरन्स, टेक्स्चर ऑर स्टोरेज प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ द फूड. तुम्हाला माहिती आहे आता सध्या नाउअडेज दिस वर्ल्ड इज ऑफ मार्केटिंग वर्ल्ड. हे सध्या जग कसं आहे, मार्केटिंगचं जग असल्यासारखं आहे. समटाईम्स थिंग्स आर अट्रॅक्टिव्ह, काही गोष्टी दिसायला अट्रॅक्टिव्ह असतात पण त्या शरीराला तेवढे पोषक असतील असं नाही. फॉर एक्झाम्पल सम फ्रुट्स ऑर फूड आयटम्स, तुम्हालाही कधी कधी माहिती आहे की ते नॅचरली नैसर्गिकरित्या न पिकवले जाता, आर्टिफिशियली कृत्रिमरित्या पिकवले जातात बाय ॲडिंग. म्हणून ॲडल्ट्रेशन म्हणजे काय? ॲडिंग अ स्मॉल क्वांटिटी ऑफ नॉन न्यूट्रिशियस सबस्टन्स, जे आपल्या शरीराला घातक आहेत असे काही घटक वापरले जातात. त्यामध्ये इंजेक्शनद्वारे ते सोडले जातात टू इम्प्रूव द अपिअरन्स. आणि त्यामुळे काय होतो, त्याला कलर चांगला येतो, अपिअरन्स दिसायला चांगले होतात, टेक्स्चर ऑर स्टोरेज प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ द फूड. कधी कधी बनानाच वी सी दॅट दे आर नॉट नॅचरली रायपन, नैसर्गिकरित्या पिकवले जात नाही, मॅटिंगने कधी कधी पिकवतात. आणि अशा आपल्या बॉडीला काय असतात, अपायकारक असतात. दे आर व्हेरी हार्मफुल फॉर अवर बॉडी. सो फूड ॲडल्ट्रेशन याचा अर्थ काय? फूड ॲडल्ट्रेशन मीन्स थोडक्यात ॲडिंग ऑफ समथिंग इन अ फूड टू इन्क्रीज वेट, कलर ऑर अपिअरन्स बट हार्मफुल फॉर बॉडी. म्हणजे दूषित करणे. ॲडल्ट्रेशनचा अर्थ काय? दूषित करणे. आणि आजकाल तुम्हाला माहिती आहे इन द मार्केट all the things we get in the market are not useful for our body. सगळ्याच गोष्टी आपल्याला मिळतात त्या आपल्या शरीरासाठी चांगलेच असतात असं नाही. बरोबर आहे. Now our main topic, organic food is grown by, do you know the concept organic food or organic farming? जैविक शेती. organic food हे कसे वापरलं जातं? by using natural materials, methods and कंडिशन्स. कसे वापरलं जातं? नॅचरल मटेरियल्स, नैसर्गिक खतं, नैसर्गिक घटक, मेथड्स अँड कंडिशन. जिथं कोणतेही पेस्टिसाइड्स कृत्रिमपणा वापरला जात नाही, रसायनं वापरली जात नाहीत, इट इज कॉल्ड एज ऑर्गॅनिक फूड, ऑर्गॅनिक फार्मिंग. ऑर्गॅनिक फर्टिलायझर. फर्टिलायझर म्हणजे काय? खत. फर्टिलायझरचा अर्थ काय? खत. ऑर्गॅनिक फर्टिलायझर मीन्स द फर्टिलायझर्स डिराइव्ड फ्रॉम ॲनिमल मॅटर्स. आता ऑर्गॅनिक आणि इनऑर्गॅनिक फार्मिंग आहे. इनऑर्गॅनिक फार्मिंगमध्ये खतं कशी असतात? कीटकनाशक असतात, फवारणी असते, वेगवेगळ्या प्रकारची औषधं असतात. पण ऑर्गॅनिक फर्टिलायझर म्हणजे जैविक खतं कोणती असतात, ती कशापासून बनवली जातात? दे आर मेड फ्रॉम द डिराइव्ड फ्रॉम द ॲनिमल मॅटर. जनावरांचं जे वेस्ट असतं, म्हणजेच फॉर एक्झाम्पल शेण ऑर वेस्ट, ह्युमन एक्सक्रेटा, ह्युमन वेस्टेज, व्हेजिटेबल मॅटर भाज्यांपासून, एक्झाम्पल कॉम्पोस्ट अँड क्रॉप रेसिड्यूज. जे पीक उरलेलं आहे पिकातून, माणसाने वापरून जे पीक काही उरलेलं असेल त्या पिकांपासून ती बनवली जातात. सो दिस इज अवर फर्स्ट आईस ब्रेकर्स ऍक्टिव्हिटी. हिअर यू विल कम टू नो दॅट दिस टेक्स्ट इज रिलेटेड विथ ॲग्रिकल्चर, food items and agriculture, and our main focus will be on organic food, organic farming. Why? We will see later. Understood? Okay. I hope you are saying yes. Okay. Now, next activity, icebreaker activity. Complete the following wave diagram. You can see on page number 25, one wave diagram is given. What is at the center? Rice varieties available at my grocer shop. Grocer manje kirana malach dukan, grocery. ग्रॉसर शॉप तुमचे एरियातल्या जो किराणा मालाचं दुकान आहे जिथून तुम्ही किराणा माल आणता तिथं कोणकोणत्या राईस व्हरायटीज आहेत भाताचे प्रकार राईस हियर आय हॅव लिस्टेड ओनली फोर फॉर यू बिकॉज ओनली फोर कॉलम्स आर देअर यू कॅन ऍड मेनी मोर आंबे मोहर बासमती इंद्रायणी चिनोर काळीसाळ एच एम टी कोलम यू कॅन गिव्ह अ नंबर ऑफ नेम्स So these are rice varieties. Now we are from organic farming, we are moving towards rice varieties. Okay, some of them are traditional rice varieties, some of them are hybrid. Kai paramparik traditional ahet, kai hybrid ahet. These are rice varieties. Okay, next icebreaker activity, first one. Find out from your grandparents or parents. Why this is given grandparents or parents? Because they are talking about past. The names of vegetables and fruits they had eaten in their childhood. Tyancha lahanpani tyanni khallele phale. Tyachi naav tyanna vichara and mention how the vegetables and fruits are different from the ones today. Now here on the left side first column you will see I have given three names. Mango, banana, lady's finger. Now are these fruits outdated? ही सगळी फळं outdated आहेत का आता मिळत नाहीत का No, you will say yes sir they are available in the market. बरोबर आहे आहेत पण फरक काय आहे What is the difference? Nowadays it is food adulterated, food adulteration. म्हणून त्यांना विचार सांगितले की त्यावेळी एवढी adulteration भेसळ नव्हती First name is mango. How is the shape? Oval or heart shaped? Oval shape किंवा heart shape असतो. Color green yellow and taste sweet. When it will taste sweet? When it will ripen naturally. जर तो नैसर्गिकरित्या पिकला तरच तो काय लागणार आहे स्वीट बनाना आपण मगाशीच उदाहरण पाहिलं बघा नाव दे आर नॉट नॅचरली रायपन मॅटनी मॅटिंगने पिकवले जातात ती केळी दे लुक येलो बट इनवर्डली दे आर नॉट रायपन C shape. How is their shape? C shape. Green yellow. When it is not ripen, piklel nasel green. Piklevarti yellow. How is the taste? Sweet. And lady's finger. Lady's finger means? Yes, bhindi. Shape oblong. Oblong shape. Sagal mahiti we all have seen. Color is green. And how is the taste? It is very crunchy and it is very favorite food of all the children. In fact, adults also like it, but mostly children eat bhindi, lady's finger. So, here the writer or they want to give you the difference between the foods or fruits available in past and available in present. Ya doni matlab farak kya hai? Okay, and now our next. One is next activity is the main theme of this chapter or main part of this chapter that is you might have learnt about organic farming tumhi kadachit aikla asel organic farming nowadays it is very popular the sadhyacha kaalamade most of the people are turning towards organic farming and they are buying organic vegetables whether they are very high costly or what But people are taking care of their health and they are buying organic food, organic vegetables. Make groups and discuss the difference between conventional farming and organic farming and write it down. What is the difference? Baga? Conventional manje paramparik ata sadhya purvi je hote pesticides vapurun kelili. And organic farming, nowadays people are moving towards organic farming. What is organic farming? We will see. कन्व्हेन्शनल फार्मिंग मध्ये काय प्रोड्यूस लार्जर क्वांटिटीज ऑफ फूड काय येत आहे तिथं लार्जर क्वांटिटीज ऑफ फूड भरपूर उत्पादन येत आहे ऑर्गॅनिक फार्मिंगला काय लेसर क्वांटिटीज ऑफ फूड त्याच्या कम्पेरिंग कन्व्हेन्शनली कम्पेरिंग तेवढं उत्पन्न येत नाहीये बट इट इज युजफुल फॉर बॉडी लेस मैन्युअल लेबर. कन्व्हेन्शनल फार्मिंग मध्ये काय, एकदा औषध मारून टाकली की माणसांचं परत कष्ट घ्यायची तिथं गरज पडणार नाही. इथं ऑर्गॅनिक फार्मिंगला काय, मोर मॅन्युअल लेबर बिकॉज दे आर नॉट युझिंग पेस्टिसाइड्स. औषधं कीटकनाशक मारत नाहीये त्यामुळे त्यांना काळजी घ्यावी लागते कीटकांपासून पिकाची. एक्स्ट्रा यूज ऑफ केमिकल्स अँड पेस्टिसाइड्स, दिस इज व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट, मे अफेक्ट इकोसिस्टीम. आत्ताच्या भाज्यांवरती काय असतं, एक्स्ट्रा यूज ऑफ केमिकल्स, भरपूर केमिकल मारली जातात, पेस्टिसाइड कीटकनाशक मारली जातात आणि कदाचित दे विल गो विथ दॅट व्हेजिटेबल इन टू अवर स्टमक अँड अफेक्ट अवर इकोसिस्टीम. आणि ऑर्गॅनिक फार्मिंग कसं आहे, मोर इकॉलॉजिकल अँड गुड फॉर हेल्थ. बट ऑर्गॅनिक फार्मिंग इज मोर इकॉलॉजिकल अँड गुड फॉर अवर हेल्थ. आपल्या शरीरासाठी पण ते कसं आहे, चांगले. सो विच वन इज व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट फॉर अस और व्हेरी यूजफुल फॉर अस, ऑर्गॅनिक फार्मिंग. सो नाऊ यू विल वंडर वाय वी आर फ्रॉम द बिगिनिंग ऑफ आईस ब्रेकर्स वाय वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट फार्मिंग, ऑर्गॅनिक फार्मिंग, देन फूड वी आर गेटिंग इन द पास्ट अँड नाऊ फूड वी आर गेटिंग इन द प्रेझेंट, डिफरन्स बिटवीन कन्व्हेन्शनल फार्मिंग अँड ऑर्गॅनिक फार्मिंग. ओके, because the title is the call of the soil, a scent of rice. In short, you will say that is there any connection, sir, is there any connection between organic farming, conventional farming and the title the call of the soil? Yes, there is connection, because when you turn to next page, come to page number 26, you will see a picture of a man, Venkateshwaran अय्यर, वेंकट अय्यर. यस, दिस मॅन इज देअर, वेंकट अय्यर, वेंकटेश्वरन अय्यर. हु इज दिस मॅन? बॉर्न इन 1966, वेंकटेश्वर अय्यर इज अ सायन्स ग्रॅज्युएट अँड अ सर्टिफाईड प्रोजेक्ट मॅनेजमेंट प्रोफेशनल. ही वॉज वर्किंग इन आयटी इंडस्ट्री. Worked in IBM company. You all are familiar with this name, International Business Machines, IBM. Computer company, first company to launch computer, IBM. For 17 years as a project manager for software implementation, this person was working in software field for 17 years as a project manager. He was a project manager. He was working in IT company. And suddenly he turned from a techie to farmer. And what is the name of his book? Moong Over Microchips. Bagata moong related with food item. And microchips is related with computer. Traces transition from techie to farmer. Transition manje change, badal. त्यांच्या आयुष्यात एक अशी घटना घडली किंवा असा एक टर्न घेतला, टर्निंग पॉइंट ऑफ लाईफ, की फ्रॉम टेकी टेक्निशियन सॉफ्टवेअर कंपनी, वर्किंग इन सॉफ्टवेअर कंपनी, ही चेंज द कोर्स ऑफ हिज लाईफ अँड ही टर्न इन टू फार्मर, टेकी टू फार्मर. सो नाव यू विल कम टू नो अबाउट द सिग्निफिकन्स ऑफ द टायटल. काय टायटल? द कॉल ऑफ द सॉइल. दिस मॅन लिसन टू द कॉल ऑफ द सॉइल. त्यांना मातीची, आपल्या जमिनीची हाक ऐकू आली, मदर अर्थची, आणि त्यांनी आपलं सगळं शहरामधलं चांगलं आयुष्य सोडलं, आयुष्य आरामाचं, अँड टर्न टू अँड रिटर्न टू द सॉइल, द कॉल ऑफ द सॉइल. इन्सिस्टेड ऑन ऑर्गॅनिक फार्मिंग. ही इज लिव्हिंग इन अ स्मॉल व्हिलेज अँड इन्सिस्टेड. And for from farming he is not getting a lot of income. He is only working for organic farming, insisted on organic farming. Not a career change but a lifestyle change. He doesn't want to change his career for getting money or to be rich. He wants a lifestyle change. He was tired of that city life, busy and very hard life. He wants a lifestyle change, so he turned or changed his life and became a farmer. Today delivers lectures about organic farming. Now he is not only limited for himself, आज बऱ्याच लोकांना मार्गदर्शन करतात कशाविषयी, ऑर्गेनिक फार्मिंग अँड वर्क्स विथ एनजीओज. एनजीओ म्हणजे नॉन गव्हर्नमेंट ऑर्गनायझेशन्स, खासगी संस्था, सरकारी नसलेले संस्था, नॉन गव्हर्नमेंट ऑर्गनायझेशन, टू प्रोपेगेट. प्रोपेगेट म्हणजे प्रचार करणे, प्रसार करणे. ऑर्गॅनिक फार्मिंग असते, ऑर्गॅनिक फार्मिंगचा सगळीकडे काय करतायत, प्रसार करतायत. अँड इन्श्युअर, वाय ही इज इन्सिस्टिंग ऑन ऑर्गॅनिक फार्मिंग, ऑर्गॅनिक फार्मिंग वरती का भर आहे त्यांचा. इन्श्युअर दॅट द लँड इज नॉट डॅमेज्ड व्हाईल मेकिंग लिव्हिंग आउट ऑफ फार्मिंग, बिकॉज ऑल यू नो दॅट इंडियाज मेन ऑक्युपेशन इज फार्मिंग. भारतातला मुख्य व्यवसाय कोणता आहे, शेती आहे. पण शेतीबरोबर लँड इज नॉट डॅमेज्ड, कारण का आत्ता उत्पन्न चांगलं आलं पण जमीनच खराब झाली तर पुढे उत्पन्न घेऊ शकणार आहे का, नाही. सो लँड इज नॉट डॅमेज्ड व्हाईल मेकिंग लिव्हिंग आउट ऑफ फार्मिंग. सो अंडरस्टूड द टायटल, द कॉल ऑफ द सॉइल, अ सेंट ऑफ राईस. व्यंकट अय्यर चेंज हिज लाईफ फ्रॉम अ टेक्निशियन ऑर टेकी सॉफ्टवेअर इंडस्ट्री to a farmer. He has become a farmer. Now before moving to the text or about the text, I just want to show you a video related with Venkat Iyer's life, and you will understand how he has changed the course of his life.
What is life if full of care? We have no time to stand and stare. No time to stand beneath the boughs and stare as long as sheep or cows. Hi, my name is Venkat, also known as Ravi to friends. I am an IT professional, born and brought up in Mumbai and educated in Mumbai and also worked in Mumbai. I worked for 17 years in the IT industry. My last job was with IBM as a project manager. Well, at the farm right now, and I have my wife with me, Meena. We have Pepper, our dog, Whitey and Minnie, the cats, Whittle, Puke and Roger, the rabbits, a lot of hens and hundreds of trees, and that's a large family we have right now. I was doing well in IBM. We had a small house. You know, our sleepy lane in Goregaon was suddenly becoming very crowded. You know, those call centers, and you know, the city was becoming unbearable. So I was looking for a change in my lifestyle. Well, we like to hike and trek, both Meena and me. So it all started off by looking for a small piece of land, like a weekend getaway, you know. So we just have a small house and we start living there. Around this time, Meena, who was a freelance journalist, was doing a research for writing a book on cotton. So as part of her research, she used to go and stay with the farmers in various villages in various states of India. And she used to come back and narrate these stories about the lives of the farmers, how they lived, what houses they had. And you know, I was quite fascinated, being a Mumbaikar and never seen a village. I was like really fascinated by these stories. One day after one of our trips, when we were discussing rural economy at home, I just popped a question to her and said, what do you think if I became a farmer? She said, yeah, why not? So that was the turning point, and the seed was sown that I will quit my corporate job, leave the city and become a farmer. At the farm, we grow everything organically. We do not use any chemicals, pesticides or external inputs. And we basically grow all the stuff that we eat. Like I have two varieties of rice, all kinds of pulses, oil, spices and seasonal vegetables. Like for example, right now we have some gajar which is growing in our field, and that takes care of our salad for right now. And we have a lot of fruit trees. I got about 5 varieties of mango, chiku, 3 varieties of guava, and passion fruit, mulberry, and cashew, lot of fruits. And spices, we have got lemongrass, basil, pepper, turmeric. I grow my own turmeric. So it more or less takes care of our kitchen. And whatever is excess, I generally sell it off in Bombay, either to shops or to friends, acquaintances who buy from me. Frankly, it all started off after I quit IBM. My friends in IBM used to say, okay, what are you up to? What are you doing? You know, this farming, organic. So keep us updated, you know. So I started sending out little emails every month or bi-monthly, depending on what's happening at the farm. Few of these people came back to me and they said, it's so interesting and so wonderful, your experiences. Why don't you compile it into a book? And much later in 2017, my experiences had increased at the farm, and the events and the anecdotes, they were different. So I decided to revisit the book, and I enhanced it, and I added a lot of information which was there over the last years after I had written the draft. And that gave birth to this book, Moong Over Microchips. Now, it says Adventures of a Techie Turned Farmer. That was the thing we decided. And the title was decided by me because the first crop that I got was moong or green gram. So that's why the title is Moong Over Microchips. Because I quit IBM Microchips and I went into Moong. So that's the story of Moong Over Microchips. And incidentally, there is a story on the cover also. If you actually touch the cover, you will feel as if it is the keyboard of a computer. So that's how they've designed it. So it's a very nice design, and well, I hope the contents also are nice. What is life if full of care? We have no time to stand and stare. No time to stand beneath the boughs and stare as long as sheep or cows. No time to see when woods we pass, where squirrels hide their nuts in the grass. No time to see in broad daylight streams full of stars like skies at night. No time to turn at beauty's glance and watch her feet, how they can dance. No time to wait till a mouth can be enriched that smile her eyes began. A poor life this is, if full of care, we have no time to stand and stare.
Okay, so now you have seen about the author Venkat Iyer, and in this video you have understood how he has changed his life and how he has developed his organic farming. And now he is not only living for himself, but he is advising people for organic farming also. So now, what is there in this chapter about the call of the soil, a scent of rice? As you all have seen in the video, or I have also told you, left his job in 2004 to start organic farming in Pet village. So he has started his organic farming in Pet village in Dahanu Taluka, Palghar district, Palghar Jilla madhya Dahanu Taluka madhe Pet village. Here he bought a small land. इथे एक छोटीशी शेती विकत घेतली आणि त्यांनी आपलं काम सुरू केलेलं होतं. And what is there in this chapter? His beginning, how he has started, the problems and challenges faced while beginning a new life. What are the problems faced by him? How he began? As you all know that from that book also he has told his first crop was moong. So you can see on page number 26. The call of the soil, scent of rice, and the title is the first crop. So now from tomorrow we are going to start with the chapter that is the call of the soil, a scent of rice, and we are going to start with the first crop, how he began his life, how he started, and the result is in front of you. You have seen in this video, तुम्ही या व्हिडिओ मध्ये पाहिले की आता सध्याची त्यांची कंडिशन काय, बट हाऊ वॉज द बिगिनिंग, सुरुवात कशी होती, वॉट ही हॅज डन. that we will see in this chapter. So I hope tomorrow you will be right on time with your textbook. You will be on page number 26. Tomorrow we'll start with the text, the call of the soil, a scent of rice. Okay, thank you very much. Do take care.